Although they thrive on the biorock, corals aren't the only primitive marine critter to find it the most attractive place around. Other invertebrates can be found growing on the biorock reefs as well.
Another member of our team here is Zak Kulberg, who is a student. He's interested in sponges and understanding the importance of sponges.
Because there's a lot of other biodiversity to look at in the sea that also grows on the biorock structures. I've been very interested specifically in looking at sponges that grow on the biorock, and certain sponges that completely encrust and grow over the biorock structure, and they're pretty difficult to find otherwise in the open water. So I go down with a few divers and take pictures to document the actual location and get a realistic look of the sponge's natural habitat underwater before it's cut, put into a test tube. Once the test tube's brought to the surface, I try to immediately decant the salt water and pour in 95% alcohol to preserve it. And that can sometimes cause a color change. About 50% of sponge extracts are active, bioactive, and have antibacterial, antifungal, antifreedant, anti-cancer properties. There's a lot of potential to develop useful medicines out of them. And a lot of this probably stems from what they're doing in their natural habitat. They can filter feed thousands and thousands of liters of water per day. In seawater, you get about 1 million bacterial cells per cubic centimeter of seawater. So they have a lot of opportunity to digest bacteria and viruses and other organisms free-floating in the water. And anything exposed to that massive amount of bacteria and viruses and fungi and all that other stuff has to be very competitive and aggressive against them. So a lot of these sponges have compounds that can kill organisms that would otherwise inhabit their tissue. When an extract from a sponge or another marine organism kills bacteria or fungus, it can be a good indicator that it can kill other cells specifically.
So it's kind of my mission to try to figure out how we can sustainably harvest something from the sea that could be useful to us later. And one step in that is identifying a region which is at risk, and then trying to figure out how we can grow organisms from that region so that they'll still persist in spite of environmental threats.
Biorock may be a very good way to cultivate organisms from the sea which have medicinal uses. It may be one of the best chances to grow these organisms.